Khadija has a strange feeling. Not only does she think she already met the man that just came the other way, but she has the weird impression that she already experienced this specific moment. It is not the first time that Khadija noticed that. Actually, it happens to her all of the time. This feeling she has, maybe you know it as well. You and your peers call that déjà vu. What makes your pitiful failure as a civilization to access the quantum world even more pathetic is that, like every life form, you have everything in you to access it. Have you ever experienced a déjà vu? If the answer is no, I feel very sorry for you, because you are even more lost than most of your peers. Two-thirds of humanity regularly experiences this feeling. I know some of your scientists try to explain it with a brain lag, but this is wrong. Neither does it mean Khadija foresees things that will be, because things are already there. Indeed, past, present, and future are only your ways to define things through time. But time is only a very specific way to see those things. Because the macroscopic world has to be considered as a block universe, everything already exists, and time is just another illusion you fool yourself with. To understand the Bloc-Universe, you need to liken it to a sheet of music. Now, imagine that this sheet contains everything macroscopic. Every element, every event, every story, from the Big Bang to the end of this world. Nobody can read this whole sheet all at once. It has to be walked through, note by note. Your lifetime, for example, would be like this bar, a very small part of the whole sheet. Very specifically located, accessible, determined. But we don't need time for it to exist. All we need is a chain of causes and consequences. Indeed, we saw in episode 4 that there is no space in the quantum world. Know now that there's no time either. Which implies that at a quantum scale, what you call the past still exists, and what you call the future already exists. This absence of time allows the quantum scale to have some form of windows on the block universe. Windows that can be opened anytime, anywhere. Given that, from a quantum scale point of view, the whole sheet is there, ready to be read. I can open any window and read any cause, following all its consequences. Khadija doesn't foresee things, she just opens windows through the quantum world, seeing and knowing determined happenings that exist before her vision even materializes. But because she only opens windows randomly, this gift reveals itself as a curse. For 5 years now, she has not watched television, nor listened to the radio, nor read the papers. This impression of déjà vu is becoming more and more intrusive. It seems to her now that she knows everything she is about to witness. She is even at a point that she experiences déjà vu of her feeling of déjà vu. The real drama for Khadija is that she will never master her gift, because we don't need her, and we never will. We don't need that many quantum-connected people for our plan, but when we do, they generally don't go unnoticed. Cassandra, Nostradamus, Baba Vanga, MacMonagle. Our help was crucial for them to master their gift of traveling through the various windows the sheet of music opens. Psychics, or mediums as you call them, have always been an important part of the quantum plan. Only I know the way to use them to read the block universe. Only I can use them to understand the past. Only I can use them to anticipate the future. I, and only I, have the power to open windows and step into your history to execute the greatest plan behind all the greatest plans.